So variables have a lot of important characteristics. And the next one we're going to talk about is super important. In fact, this is something you need to know for every statistical test that you would do. This is what determines which test you're going to use. It's more important than whether you do an experiment or a correlational study. This is what tells you if you need to do a t-test or an ANOVA or anything like that, which we'll talk about later on. And so this characteristic of variables is sometimes called the scales of measure. Sometimes it's called the levels of measure. But there's a few different ways that folks describe these. I'm going to describe the way that we most commonly do it in psychology. And here's an acronym that'll hopefully help you remember these scales of measure. There's four of them that we're going to use, right? And so NOIR is French for black. Noir is a film genre, right? That's like the dark and spooky movies like Blade Runner. But it's also the first four letters of the four scales of measure. So N is for nominal, and these are also known as categorical. And variables that are nominal have values that are groups or categories. So for example, biological sex, a man or woman would be a categorical variable. Year in school, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior would be considered a categorical variable. Eye color, hair color of your car, anything where you're measuring something and each observation falls into one group or one category. That's a nominal variable. O is for ordinal variables. And these are ranks. So these are something that people are familiar with from competitions, where you have first place, second place, third place, fourth place, and so on. Those are their ranks. So examples of this are races, or more specifically, like gold medal, silver medal in the Olympics and things like that. And notice here, somebody might have first place, somebody else might have second place, somebody else might have third and fourth and fifth and so on. And for ordinal, each person should have a unique rank, ideally. But notice that the first person, you know, they did better than the second person, but you don't know by how much. It could have been 10 seconds, it could have been 10 minutes. You can't tell from an ordinal measure. Second person did better than third person, but you can't tell by how much. So ordinal variables, they tell you how to sort the observations from low to high, but they don't tell you how much the different measures are apart from each other. Both interval and ratio do tell you these distances. So interval and ratio are the other two scales of measure, and these two are pretty similar to each other. And in psychology, we treat them pretty much the same as each other. And both of these have equal intervals . And what that means is the amount of whatever it is that you're measuring between 1 and 2, that amount is the same as between 2 and 3. So if we're measuring pounds and somebody is 110 pounds and somebody else is 111 pounds, the difference between those is 1 pound. And if somebody is 130 and somebody else is 131, this difference is also 1 pound. So that's what it means for equal intervals. That's, notice ranks or ordinal variables, they don't have equal intervals. You don't know how much distance is between the one and the two and then two and the three. For both interval and ratio, the distances are always the same, right? They have equal intervals. Ratio and interval differ in one key way. Ratio variables have a true zero, whereas interval variables do not. So I'll say no true zero. So an example of an interval variable is temperature measured with Fahrenheit. Or temperature measured with Celsius as well. And for either one of these, going from one number to the next is the same amount of change in temperature. But for neither one does zero mean that there is no heat present, right? Because for Fahrenheit, you could have 1 degree Fahrenheit, 0 degree Fahrenheit, and -1 degree Fahrenheit. The amount of temperature change is the same. But for zero, there's still heat present. For -1, there's still heat present. The same is true of Celsius, right? For Celsius, this would be thawing frozen water, and this would be freezing water that's not frozen, but it's still 1 degree difference. A ratio has a true zero. An example of this would for temperature is the Kelvin scale. For Kelvin, the lowest temperature measure you can have is zero. And Kelvin, the measure of zero means there's no heat there at all. That only occur like in the vacuum of space, or even, I don't even know if they get that vacuum, if there's even that good of vacuums in space, right? So zero means that there's no heat at all, and then one would mean there's some, two would mean there's even more. Notice these ratio variables are actually the kind of number we're most familiar with, right? Whenever you count something, that's a ratio scale. Zero means there isn't any there. One means there's one, two is two, and so on. Now, these intervals are a little bit strange. They're uncommon in nature, if you will. But ratio, this is really common because it, like anything that you count or if you just measure it, that's going to be a ratio. And notice for ratio, there's no negative numbers. Negative numbers don't even make sense. If you asked somebody, how tall are you? And they said they're -3 feet tall, you'd say, that doesn't make any sense. And that's because it's a ratio variable. If you ask somebody how many candies they gave out over Halloween, and they said -15, that doesn't make any sense because the number they gave out is ratio. So these ratio variables are the kinds of variables that we're probably most familiar with, ratio and groups, right? We're also really familiar with groups. Ranks are pretty common when you're comparing different things across one variable. That's pretty common, but these intervals are the least common in the real world. In psychology, we do a kind of measure that is really common. And for us, we consider it to be an interval scale variable. And the kind of measure I'm talking about is where you're answering some questions, and the questionnaire might ask you something like, on a 1 to 5 scale, where 1 is very unhappy, and 5 is very happy, where are you? Right, these are called Likert scales or Likert type scales. And maybe right now I'd say I'm a 4, right? I'm feeling pretty happy here. So in psychology, we treat these kinds of measures as interval scale measures. Some other fields like to think of them more as ranks. where 4 is higher than 3, and 3 is higher than 2, and 2 is higher than 1, for example. Of course, 5 is higher than 4. And if you consider them to be ranks, then you don't assume that these intervals between these are equal to each other. But in psychology, we do assume that those intervals are equal. And also notice that they aren't ratio. You can't get below 0 with this scale, but these numbers are completely arbitrary, right? So the researcher, when they came up with their 1 to 5 scale, they could have instead made it like this. It's the exact same scale, the exact same information, but just written this way, this is what I would have put. And now there are negative numbers. And so the self-report scale in psychology is something we'll treat that as an interval variable. And I want to explain one more thing about ratio variables that actually is what gives them their name. Let's say that we're measuring how many cookies kids get, right? So some kids get 0 cookies, some kids get 1, some kids get 2, and some kids get 3 cookies, right? This is just the number of cookies they get. Notice that kids could not get negative 4 cookies. That doesn't make any sense. And so that fits with ratio, not with interval. And having 1, between 0 and 1, there's 1 cookie difference. Between 1 and 2 is 1 cookie difference. Between 2 and 3, that's 1 cookie difference. So we have equal intervals. So it's not ranks, right? So that's why the number of cookies that kids get is ratio. But the reason it's called ratio is because 2 is twice as many as 1, right? 4 would be twice as many as 2. Those kinds of ratios only make sense with ratio variables. If your happiness is 2 on this scale and my happiness is 1, that does not make you twice as happy as me. It just doesn't make any sense with these interval scales to say that 2 is twice 1 or 4 is 4 times as 1. But it totally makes sense with these ratio variables, which again are just the most normal numbers that you're familiar with. I want to point out a couple more things about scales of measure and how they relate to research and statistics. So the first thing I want to point out is that interval and ratio variables, for a class like this, you'll need to be able to tell for any variable whether it's interval or ratio, but when we're doing statistics, we actually treat these the same. And we'll talk more about that a little bit later on. And I also wanted to connect these ideas to experiments and correlational studies a little bit. So we talked about an example where a researcher does an experiment where they give some participants caffeinated coffee and other folks decaffeinated coffee. So in that case, the beverage variable would be nominal, because it'd be two groups, caffeinated or decaffeinated. And if the participants report how tired they are on a 1 to 10 scale, then in that example, the outcome variable, this is the independent variable, the IV, the independent variable. And in that, if somebody's self-reporting how tired they are in that experiment, then the dependent variable is interval. Self-reported tiredness on 1 to 10 scale. Notice we could have done the exact same experiment, given them caffeinated coffee or decaffeinated coffee, and then done a different kind of measure that could have been a ratio scale. For example, we could have put them in a really boring situation. Maybe had them watch a stats video or something like that, and watched how many times, counted how many times they nod off, that they start to fall asleep. And so this would have been, something where 0 is the minimum value, and if you nod off 2 times, that's half as many as nodding off 4 times. So in that case, the outcome variable would have been a ratio scale of measure variable. here. So this would have been the DV with that scenario. It's pretty uncommon for psychologists to use ordinal variables. We do it sometimes, but in this class, we're actually going to be focusing on statistical tests where the dependent variable or the outcome or effect variable is interval or ratio. And we're going to have causal variables that are nominal, and we'll have some causal variables that are interval or ratio as well, eventually. When the causal variable is interval or ratio, it's almost never an experiment. When you do an experiment, usually the causal variable is nominal. All right, I'm going to do a quick recap. Right, so these are the scales of measure, sometimes called levels of measure. So nominal variables, these are groups or categories, male, female, who you voted for, right? It's one or the other, like Democrat or Republican or something like that. Ordinal, these are ranks, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on. Interval scale measure variables are regular numbers, but with no true zero. Zero doesn't mean that there's nothing there, where it does in ratio. Right, so for example, an interval scale might be on a 1 to 5 scale, how happy are you? Whereas for a ratio variable, counts are a common kind of ratio, or let me mean a measure of distance or something like that. And in psychology, we treat these the same. They are interchangeable when we do our statistics and stuff. But you'll still need to know the difference between them for this class.